135 miles north of Florida Gulf Coast University sits several acres of land surrounding the Pasco County Jail. To the untrained eye, the property may seem nondescript.
Our mantra is always having a living laboratory.
But this area of marshy tall grass is called the Outdoor Forensics Laboratory, a training ground where students in FGCU's Forensic Studies program research decomposing bodies.
Get it down.
In Florida's unique soil.
We focus on making sure that our scientists are educators and that we find ways to take difficult information and present it in a way that the students hold on to it and they understand the stories behind its utility so that it reaches a deeper part of learning.
The Outdoor Forensics Laboratory, commonly known as a body farm, is the only one of its kind in Florida. Students work with state-of-the-art equipment to learn how to locate, excavate, and recover surface scattered and buried remains with the help of human detector dogs.
You're in a state like Florida with a subtropical environment that is brutally hot. We have insects and snakes and other types of animals out here that sometimes pose a threat, and this creates a safe space for the students to work.
So we can stop here.
Dianira Lopez, a lab coordinator at FGCU, pushes radar equipment across the ground. It resembles a large push lawnmower, but is connected to a tablet that can read what may be buried in the ground below.
But nothing concerning there. This looks great.
Currently, this facility does not have any bodies in it. Donations have slowed because of COVID-19. But when bodies are donated, the remains will be buried or left above ground to be exposed to elements like sun and rain, mimicking the various scenarios officials could come across when working on cases that involve fatalities.
When you're in the classroom, you learn it, and you learn it from people who are professionals in the field, but it's very different when you get to actually see it in action.
This training is made possible by a partnership with Florida's Forensics Institute for Research, Security, and Tactics, or FIRST, a program managed by the Pasco County Sheriff's Office.
Our job is basically to look at ways where we can find gaps within the arena of first responders and law enforcement and find out ways to solve some of those problems and to create different trainings that allow for us to be more proficient in what we do.
FIRST approached FGCU after hearing about Dr. Walsh Haney's extensive background in forensic science and her work with law enforcement to help locate and uncover the dead.
I responded to the tragedy of September 11, as well as helping out to locate remains associated with Hurricanes Wilma and Katrina. And so what they did with FIRST is reach out to me to discuss how we could make a safe training venue, again, for students and practitioners.
This is just like a big puzzle, right? You have to find the answer to something, whether it's doing biological assessment or whether it's excavating anything and trying to find a clandestine grave. It's just a big puzzle.
This opportunity, working outdoors, working with the instruments, talking to law enforcement and medical examiners, where they talk about real world cases, help the students learn on a deeper level.
A few hundred yards away sits another hands-on training facility known as the Urban Search and Rescue Rubble Piles. They are constructed to simulate different types of disasters like a bombing, terrorist attack, or collapse of a parking garage.
Having the ability to hoist off of three stories and then be able to go into a find type of situation, being able to deploy our canine handlers on that site and then have them to be able to locate individuals within that that facility. It really gives us a strong template for repetition of training that you often cannot get unless an actual disaster takes place.
It's invaluable to be down here in this program and to be a part of it.
FGCU students are receiving training most do not get until they are years into their career. The hands-on and collaborative experience is why graduate student Sonia Concepcion Jones moved across the country for the program.
To have all women, mostly women in our program, and to be led by Dr. Heather Walsh Haney, it really does mean a lot to me as a woman and a woman of color to be around supportive individuals that are like-minded as myself.
Her itch for the industry came from watching TV shows like CSI and Bones. Her motivation now comes from the family she is helping with the answer she is finding.
That's something that has stuck with me and motivated me to continue on in this career from the beginning, is knowing that I am helping give answers to people that don't have a voice for themselves.